On his return to Barbados, Hoyt, along with several colleagues, founded the Nation newspaper in 1973, where he served as editor-in-chief for 3 decades.
He returned to Barbados after having served in many media institutions in Canada, including being editor of a newspaper called Contrast, which covered not only the black and white interracial racial struggle, but also looked at providing heavy coverage to the Caribbean diaspora in Canada. And returning to Barbados with that type of orientation, he established the Nation newspaper in 1979, along with another guy called Patrick Hoyos and a photographer called Al Jilks, and between them they created the Nation in a way that it moved from just a newspaper in Barbados to a corporation that served the entire region. The Nation spawned something called the EC News, of which I was proud to be a prime contributor, which looked at providing coverage on what's happening in the OECS out of Barbados through correspondents like myself here.
On Sunday, the Barbados Association of Journalists and Media Workers said his death has left a gaping hole in the media fraternity.
Harold Hoyt also came to St. Lucia to participate in one of the conventions, annual conventions of the St. Lucia Media Workers Association, as well as to participate on behalf of the Caribbean Association of Media Workers. He contributed to the formation of nearly everyone who's somebody in the media in Barbados today. He contributed in such a great way that Prime Minister Mia Mottley has agreed to grant him a state funeral.
Mr. Buske says all St. Lucian journalists and media personnel who know and did not know him will get to know of and appreciate the contribution of Harold Hoyt to the history of media in Barbados, the Caribbean, and the world. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Buske.